Want to know more about those people behind the videos on YouTube? Want to know what makes them tick? What got them started? Well, you're looking at the right program. This is Behind the Cam. Now, in your videos, you do a lot of bragging about what you have, all the women, or as you say, pussy, that you have. You got the Pussy Fest 2010, or whatever that is. You even so-called got a female fan base called a Week of the Pussy, something like that. So, is all that bragging for show, or is that really you? And how do you respond to those people that just take you as a joke?
Again, going back to what trash talking is, it's a tradition to use humor and sarcasm as a weapon. Those are very powerful weapons against other teams. So I enjoy having the ability to help make other people laugh. At the other fan bases. That's a power that I think is very important to trash talking. I think that making people laugh is a big part of that. So I'm all for using humor to get a point across.
Okay, so I guess I can take it from your answer, since you really didn't say it or not, but I will assume that you're saying that the bragging and the arrogance isn't you, is just for show. If not, hit me up a response when you see the show. But moving to the next question, I know I did a video about this. So, just for the record, in your own words, do you consider yourself the leader of Stripe Fury or any other Bengals TTC group or fan base or whatever?
Absolutely not. I've said before, I don't represent anybody other than myself. I represent the Bengals, but you know, not everybody is going to agree with the way that I represent them. And that's fine. I don't necessarily agree with the way they represent them either. So no, I don't speak for a group of people. I don't consider myself the leader of anything. I'm actually no longer a member of Striped Fury because I thought that would... It was creating some controversy there that, you know, I really didn't want people to have to go through. I'm a lone wolf, you know. I am an independent trash talker. I rep the Bengals. But I don't want to be known as someone who speaks for other people or anything like that. That's not what I do. I'm not the leader of Striped Fury or any other Bengals group. No.
So what do you consider your style of video making? Because for a lot of people, they consider it brash and in-your-face style. But what do you consider your video style? And do you have any YouTube video makers out there that you watch or that you admire or that inspired you in any way?
Style of vid making, controversial and entertaining. And I think that's important. People want to watch my vids. Whether they agree with what I have to say, totally disagree with what I have to say, whether they think I'm just some kind of big joke, or whether they take me very seriously, people watch my vids. They want to see what I'm saying. And that's because of the style that I have. It's controversial, it's confrontational, and it's also very entertaining. It's something that people feel a need to watch. As for favorite video maker, I don't really want to get into that. There's a lot of video makers that I have respect for how they choose to approach trash talking. Cop Hizzle is one of them. He was one of the first guys that I found on here back when I first discovered the TTC. Bryn7 is one. Steel Legends is one. Josh GoBangle17 is one. Grubbs was one. You know, Joe BeMoreRavens Online 2. You know, just everyone that I've ever seen here on the TTC had an influence on me. I have my own style, I have my own way of doing things, but those are the people who I learned a lot from about what the TTC is and what it stands for.
Okay, I'm hurt. You didn't say me in there. I've been around here for about 4 years, 4+ years, and you didn't say me, but hey, that's okay. I'm just joking, man. I'm just joking. All right, last question. There has been a challenge put out there by the Big Gravy. We all know what it is. He wants you to, since you brag so much about your big house and all the pussy and all that stuff like that you get, he's saying fly him out there, put him in the room, let him see this, that, and the other. And if it's all true, he'll go out there and say you ain't no fake liar. So they basically come out there and say, yeah, you the gospel. You say it like it is, and you live the life that you say you live. So tell us, are you going to take him up on his offer?
I'm obviously not going to go out and give people personal information about me. That is not something that I'm going to be doing for anyone on here. Nobody is going to get any kind of information like that. So that's an absurd challenge, because anybody on here with any sort of intelligence is not going to get online and give someone that they don't even know where they live and information like that. So no, I don't take that challenge seriously, and I'm not going to respond to it.
Well, thank you again, YearOfTheTiger513, for being on this edition of Behind the Cam. I hope for all the viewers out there, I hope you found this informative and enlightening. So you can hit me up at BigDRavens@Comcast.net. That's BigDRavens@Comcast.net. All one word. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know what you want to see. If you want to be on the show, hit me up. Let me know. Send me a personal message over here or here in the message bar. Depending on which way it is, I don't know. Whatever. Hopefully, the next one, it's going to be, I guess, Grubbs or the Big Gravy, whichever one decides to. So just hit me up again, either one of you two, when you watch it. Hey, let me know. We'll be on here. I'll be fair to you, just like I was fair to everybody else. So again, this is Big D. This is Behind the Cam. Thank you for watching, and have a good day.